Folks, hey, this is Wesley, Billion Dollar Virgin. Welcome to another Millionaire Midnight Rant. It's approximately 1:38 a.m. here in Houston, Texas. And I'm late, but so what? I'm working. Okay? And tonight's video is entitled, How Much Work to Earn $1 Million? Okay? Like, how much work is required? It's really necessary to make your first $1 million, you know what I mean? Actually having $1 million in a bank account here. I want to talk about that here tonight. So folks, if you're up, and you should be up, if you're serious about making money and actually expanding your life and developing your skills, it shouldn't be sleep. And if you don't know who I am, my name is Wesley, Billion Dollar Virgin. I'm a young, self-made millionaire from Houston, Texas. Grew up pretty poor and average, but over the years, I became a multimillionaire at the age of 35. And now, I spend my time in the dark talking to you on Instagram Live, sharing my philosophy about wealth, law of attraction, manifestation, and just general entrepreneurship here. I am in a digital marketing world, which is a beautiful world to be in. Basically, I print money for a living. That's just the amount of money that you make on the internet here. But I'm here to help you as well and share my philosophy with you so you don't have to die a poor, average person, okay? So let's talk about it here. And I just want to get right into it if you don't mind, since I'm late tonight. Yeah, many of you don't realize how much work it takes to make your first million. Comment these words below, a lot. Okay? Comment that word below, a lot. Okay? I mean, it's a lot of work. Like, I'm already worth several millions of dollars, and I'm working. That's what I was doing right before I went live. I'm working, 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 working. And if you believe that you can achieve millions of dollars consistently without an insane work ethic, you're fooling yourself. Okay? It's going to be the first one to tell you you're fooling yourself. Like, if you're sleeping right now, if you're in the bed, I'm just going to be honest with you here. I don't want to discourage you, but I'll be very honest with you. If you're in bed right now, sleeping, you know, and you're thinking that if you're an entrepreneur, starting a brand new business, or trying to get your business to the point that you're profitable, or making money and you're sleeping, you're never going to earn $1 million. It's never going to happen for you. Okay? And if you do, you're not going to sustain it. It's bloody hard to make $1 million. Almost impossible. I think I've shared the statistic before. 1,700 people per day out of billions of people become millionaires. 1,800. That's less than 1% of the world. Become millionaires every single day. Okay? 1,700 people. And if you truly believe that you can work less, especially in the beginning, you know, once you really figured out the game, you know, there are ways to make money, but you can't learn the game until you play the season. Like, you can't go to the playoffs or the championship in football nor basketball until you play the season. And you got to play it well. Okay? And it's a lot of work. And we're talking about practices. We're talking about late nights. I mean, think about a football, a basketball, tennis player, golf player, soccer player. I mean, these people that are doing very well, Ronaldo, Messi, and, you know, Kobe Bryant and LeBron James. I mean, the work ethic is insane. I mean, it's just a lot of work, a lot of skill, just a lot of repetition. And I don't think this generation understands the amount of work that it takes to become a millionaire. Because I think the internet has painted a picture for you to make you believe that it's easier than what it really is. Listen, it is hard. It's almost impossible. Okay? And if you're not the smartest in the bunch, if you're not the most intellectual, working hard and longer is just the name of the game. I give you an example. See if you're a salesperson, but you have another person that sells better than you. Well, that means that you need to sell more. That means more hours have to be put into the sales process for you to be at the top. It's no other way. Like, it's no breaks. It's no, relaxing. And I know, I get it. You might say, oh, don't you take a break sometime? I got to relax. No. I mean, I'm just being honest with you. No. You know, somebody that truly wants to achieve their goal, the last thing they're thinking about is taking a break, eating, taking a shower. They don't have time for this because they're committed to getting better. And until you get better, you're not going to be rewarded with millions of dollars. Does that make sense? Again, it is bloody hard to be a high-performance person. It is bloody hard to make $1 million. And most of you would never make $1 million. And now, this is not meant to be negative. It's just the truth. You know, 99% of you are not going to make $1 million. And it's not because you can't do it. You're just not willing to do what's necessary because I don't think you realize the amount of work ethic. For example, right now, you should be working. Like, I promise you, 95% of you do not have $100,000 in your bank account. Like, you don't even have $100,000, and you're talking about you're going to be a millionaire one day, sleeping like a baby, under your covers, resting. And your only complaint is you got to go to work tomorrow morning. So what? I mean, what does that mean? There are many people, including myself. I had a job at one time. And I had a job. And when I got home, I worked on the business. And I didn't get to the bed maybe at 4, 5 o'clock sometime every night for years. Okay? And you're complaining because you have a job. That means you can't work longer, or you worked all day. You can't put in more hours. Bullshit. Well, you'll never be rich. You know, I heard that from one of my team members. You know, I'm thinking to myself, I didn't say anything, but they said, well, you know, there's no way I could put in more hours. I just can't. Well, you probably would never be rich. I'm going to be honest with you. You probably never be truly successful on the level that you want to be successful on. And that's okay if you can't. Obviously, 97% of the world cannot. They're just not going to do it. They feel that they can't. But I want you to remember something. It's somebody on this planet that's just like you, same exact situation, just like you, and they find a way to put in more hours. They do. Yeah, maybe they got to go to work tomorrow. Maybe they're going to be sleepy. They go to Starbucks, drink some coffee, and they do it again every single day. Does that make sense? You know, this generation, and even the younger generation, teenagers and, you know, early 20s, you guys are doomed. I mean, because you don't realize the work ethic that is necessary. I mean, it's like a blessing and a curse. So many opportunities out there. And then the curse is so many opportunities out there, and you think the opportunities is going to get you where you want to be very quickly. But no, that's not the case. It's not going to happen quick. Still got to build a skill. Does that make sense? You still have to put in the work. The late nights. It's no sleeping. Does that make sense, ladies and gentlemen? Okay. It's not. And you have to be prepared to do this for years. Like, imagine doing this for years. Working without any results for years. Many of you can't even do it for 1 month. It takes a lot of work. I mean, you just get used to it. You might say, well, when do you have, you know, you get used to the work. Honestly, you just get used to the work ethic. And if you don't get used to and very familiar with the work ethic, then you're going to lose money. You will lose money every single year. You'll see it. Money is going to be extracted from your bank account. You're going to just lose money. Broken, and broken. More debt, more debt, more debt. Because you're not willing to put in the work, man. Does that make sense, everyone? And I know I have some single mothers on here. Say, oh, I got children. So what? You made them. So what? Just being honest with you. Like, no one cares. You know, when I hear people complain about, like, spending single mothers. You know, shout out to the single mothers. But, like, no one cares that you have a bunch of children. Okay? No one cares that it's hard for a single mother. Like success and money, it doesn't care. You still got to put in a ton of work, and it's a ton of sacrifice. There are going to be times you can't spend time with your children. They're going to want to spend time, but you can't because you got to work. And they're not going to understand it at all because they're going to want you right then and right now. But if you want to be highly successful, there's a sacrifice. Does that make sense, ladies and gentlemen? There's a sacrifice that you have to make. Okay? I mean, even, you know, men, relationships, maybe find a girl of your dreams, woman of your dreams. Okay, so what? And the woman wants all your time. Got a decision to make, fellas. It's either going to be her or the business. And if she don't understand how to support you as you build the business, she's going to be a hindrance. You'll see it. And I get it. So many men, because, you know, men talk to me about how they're going to stay with their woman and make $1 million. I'm like, okay, whatever. I haven't met one yet. I'm not saying it's impossible, but it is highly unlikely to do it with a woman. It's very difficult. Because many women don't know how to support a man that's working towards becoming a high-performance individual. They don't know how to support a man like that. So she just become a distraction. Man, I'm going to tell you this one time and one time only. If you're in a situation with a woman right now, and you're not where you want to be or where you should be financially, let her go. Break it off. Leave her. You can love her and leave her. Leave her and love her. Still can love her. But the thing is, you want your mind to be totally clear when you're working and focused. You can't be thinking about, oh my God, I forgot to call my girl. Oh my God, I forgot to go see her. Oh my God, I forgot to text her back. You don't want any of that on your mind at all. You just want your work in front of you. Does that make sense? You want to be laser-like focused on what you are trying to build because that's what it takes. And I mean, it takes hours and hours and long hours. And listen, you'll realize it. It's just normal. It's not like it's, you know. Yeah, I know some of you are like, well, when does it stop? I mean, you know, whenever you ask those type of questions, like, when do I have to stop working so much so I'm going to be relaxed and I can chill? You're never going to be successful because rich people don't think like that. They don't think just chilling and relaxing. Maybe when they're in the 60s and 70s, but come on, 20s, 30s, and 40s, and 50s, it's grind time, it's working. Okay? I mean, only if you want to be a high-performance person and high-performance people, they make millions of dollars. Does that make sense, ladies and gentlemen? It's a lot of work. It's insane. Just think about the amount of work that you're putting in right now. Well, multiply that times 10. Okay. And imagine that work ethic every day for 5 to 10 years with no guarantee that you're going to make $1 million. But that makes it even difficult. You know, it's no guarantee. It's tough. But see, to be honest with you, that's why it's so simple to be successful, because like no one's willing to really work hard. They're not willing to do it. Put in the long hours, like every day for years. They're not willing to do it. So it's only a few, because the people that are not willing to do it, they're too busy looking for the easy way or the faster way or the easiest way to make money, the fastest. And it doesn't exist, first of all, right? But you still got stupid, dumb people out there that's still looking for the easy and fast way. And they will always be looking for the easy and fastest way to find out it doesn't exist. Does that make sense? You know, some of you, honestly, it's just, again, I'm not being negative, but some of you just need to stop pursuing millions of dollars because you're not putting in the work ethic. Like, you're not willing to do it. You're not willing to sacrifice. You're not willing to separate from social media. You're not willing to stop watching TV. You're not willing to stop watching Netflix, stop watching movies, Amazon Prime, Hulu, Zulu. You're not willing to stop playing the games. You're not willing to stop hanging out with your broke average friends. Like, you know what's mind-boggling to me? How do people expect to be rich and wealthy, but they're so familiar and connected to their broken average friends? Like, come on. So you think you're going to be rich as you hang around your broken average friends? Your co-workers, you're not willing to do anything to become a high performance person. You're not all of you, you're just not willing to do it. If I tell you guys to get out to bed right now and get to work on whatever project, whatever business you're working in, like, get up. It's always something to do, period. Always something to do in your business. And the first thing you should focus on is the acquisition of customers. But how many of you are going to actually get out of your bed? None of you. You're going to lay in your bed, just relax and say, I'll do it tomorrow. Oh, I do it later. I do it later. I do it later. I do it later. Listen, the amount of money you have in your bank account, that's it. Every once in a while, you may get a spurt here and a spurt there, but you'll never have real money. And you never do the things that, you know, most people dream about. Never. All because you're not willing to get out of your bed right now and get to work. Like, this is the best time to work, like, right now. Okay? Right now is the best time to put in the work. Everybody's asleep. Like, everybody in United States of America, they're asleep over here. Other parts of the world, they're up. But think about the people that are working right now. And you probably have more than 90% of people in America and U.S., they're asleep right now. But you got another 10% that are putting in that work right now. And you're sleeping, talking about you need your beauty rest, not even beautiful, and thinking you're going to be a millionaire. Nah. It's a lot of work. I mean, the amount of work is insane. And then, you know, it's not just the work. It's the work and the reward. It takes forever. It's going to take a long time. It just does. It just takes a while. Because until you build a skill, I'll be honest, some people are a bit gifted, right? Some people can figure out things faster than others. And some people it takes longer for. And you may be one of those people that it's just going to take a bit longer to achieve what you're trying to achieve. Does that make sense? It's just going to take you longer. So I would suggest, if you're not willing to put in this amount of work, just don't do it. Don't even waste your time. Like, just don't do it. Just stay at your job. It's okay. Stay at the 9 to 5, 3 to 11, you know, just clock in, clock out. You know, at least you get a paycheck every 2 weeks. You know, I would say do that because many of you don't realize the game that you're in when you're trying to be rich and wealthy and making millions of dollars. I don't think you realize the game that you're in. It's bloody difficult, almost impossible. Okay? Like some of you complain about motivation. You can't get yourself motivated. You'll never be rich. If you cannot self-motivate yourself to do what you're supposed to do, you'll never be rich. Never. I bet all my money on it. Never. If you can't motivate yourself, if you can't get yourself to do what's necessary, if you can't tell yourself what to do and actually follow through, you'll never be rich. Never. I mean, let's be honest with you. If you're that person, I need motivation, you'll never be rich. You just won't, ever. Until you learn how to motivate yourself. Does that make sense, ladies and gentlemen? Okay. Does that make sense? It's hard, man. It's bloody difficult. Only in the beginning, though. Like right now, it's easy for me. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. Simple. It's not difficult for me to do these rants and serve you and work. It's simple for me. I'm accustomed to it. I can't breathe up my left nostril. Sometimes I fall off the wagon and get lazy, but then I get right back on and keep learning. Yeah, listen, I get it. That sounds good, right? But if you refer to yourself as a lazy person, oh, I get lazy, you're probably never going to be rich. And I love you, young lady. I mean, honestly, but I'm just going to be honest with you because successful people, they lazy is not even a part of their vocabulary. Like, they don't get lazy. They just don't. They don't get lazy. Not when it comes to achieving their dreams and accomplishing their goals and making money. I mean, especially in the beginning, in the inception stages of a business or a company, they don't have time to be lazy. Many of you think it's a luxury for you to fall off the bandwagon, be lazy, and just get back on. And then you say, oh, I'm just learning. What do you learn? You learned that you're lazy? You already knew that. You're probably not going to make $1 million more than likely. Okay? How many of you are taking action daily? I'm just curious. And how many of you not only are taking action, like you're working in the midnight hours? I mean, it's always work. And like I said, the work that you should be doing is bringing in customers to your business, selling your product. That's it. Or finding ways to sell your product. Understanding your numbers. Understanding the accounting part of the business. How many of you are doing that? Any questions for me here? And I get it, you know, everybody's going to like, oh, Wesley, I'm taking action. I'm doing this. Yeah. Sure you are. Sure. Wesley, I'm working my ass. I'm working. I'm putting in that work right now. Sure you are. How long? How many months? How many years? Okay. Any questions for me before I let you go? What discourages anyone you're pour more effort and earning little? What discourage? That doesn't make sense, Felix. See, many of you might think, oh my God, you up at 2 o'clock in the morning doing a rant? Yeah, but this is easy for me. To you, it's hard work. See, many of you will call this hard work. You're like, well, 2 o'clock in the morning, I'm asleep. 2 o'clock in the morning, I don't want to talk, right? But to me, it's easy. So what you call easy, I call simple. It's easy for me to work 10 plus hours. Simple. What's next here, folks? Questions here. What to do when you're a consistent trader but got no funds to invest? Find the funds. Find the money. Okay? Find the money. It's one thing about successful people. They're very creative people. Poor and average people, they're not creative at all. They just have problems and, oh, what do I do with it? What do I do? And it's like, they're not even creative. You got to be creative, man. Think outside the box. How can you get the money so you can trade? It's always a way, if you think about it. But many of you, you just give up too quickly. You're like, oh, I don't know how to get this. I don't know how to get this money. I don't know how to get this. I can't do this. I can't do this. It's too much for me. Too much stress. Too much this. Too much that. You're going to be a loser for the rest of your life, in my opinion. I've heard so many people get stressed. You know, I get stressed out with business. All of those stressed out. I'm like, well, you need to be working for somebody then. Since he's so stressed out running the business. I mean, I met a ton of people. You know, I had to stop that business. It was just stressing me out. It was just too much. Yeah, exactly. You deserve to be an employee. Work for someone for the rest of your life. And so many people do that. You know, they fall and go back to their jobs where it's safe. In their opinion, losers. Just my opinion. I think those are losers. You know, people that give up on their dreams are losers because they have just chosen to lose, just gave up. You know. Somebody says, that's not nice. Shit. The world's not nice. Listen, if you can't take it from me, the world gonna tear that ass up. See, I know a lot of you are not gonna like what I'm saying because you want me to say everything that's positive, right, and optimistic to you. I know. And I am a positive person. But I gotta give it to you raw. Right? I gotta tell you like it is. 1,700 people are millionaires every single day. Less than 1%. That's just the truth. So why would you be one? What are you doing to become a multi-millionaire? What are you doing to become a multi-millionaire, folks? All right, any questions for me here? Had a good time tonight. Come with the word value if you got value here. Remember, I have a podcast. You can find me on Apple Podcasts and download the podcast. It's free to be able to get more information, more advice, more gems like this. So you can get the insights of what it takes to be a multimillionaire. Because you might find out that it's just not for you. And it's okay if it's not. It's not for most people. Most people will die working for other people. And that's okay. Some of you are just so weak. Oh, my God. You know, listen, if you allow my words, if I say, you know, you're not going to be rich. And if you allow my words hurt your little tender feelings, you're not going to be rich. What you should say is, no, I'm going to do it. I'm going to make it happen. You should say. But you don't say it because you ain't got it in you. Make sense? You ain't got that dog in you. I got that dog in me, boy. If I want something, I'm going to eat it. I'm going to tear that ass up. If I want it, it's mine. I got that dog in me. Any of you don't have nothing in you. You're weak. You're tender. Tender, looking at just tender, man. Too weak. You can't play this game, and you can't play this game and be a sensitive person. It's just you're gonna wind up a casualty. Okay. Oof. All right. Any more questions for me, folks? Before I let you go. I got to get back to work. All right, much love, folks. This is Wesley, $1 billion virgin. And let's go.